We're gonna end up going way too slow behind that Jeep. We're gonna tip over. We'll go ahead and stop here for a minute. I've been trying to find this. I've been up a few times in the Pisgah National Forest trying to find this, and I never can. I don't know how to get the kickstand up in these new boots, I'll be honest. Alright, Marco. Let's see what you got. Oop. There's first. I'm gonna kind of inch it over so I don't have any momentum. Let's go slow. Actually quite a bit of work. Big old heavy girl. A little hard to manipulate this bike. Ooh. That I don't know about. Yeah, if I wasn't by myself. Shit. Yeah, that's pretty. I'm sure it's fine. I just know that those rocks are going to be super, super slippery. And if I lose the bike and it gets really wet, I might not be able to get started. Let's try a different mode. Let's try, there's one that's gravel. I rode that last time, it seemed to be pretty good, so. That's the first job. There we go. Pisgah National Forest, baby. Woo! I have been here once before. I brought the truck out here one time. Hopefully these aren't too deep. Whoa, shit. Yeah, they're pretty fucking deep. Oh my god. Oh, oh. That went all the way inside my helmet. Oh. That had to be like 2 feet deep. Or maybe deeper. Oh, man. I should have closed my visor. Oh. There's some snow. Right in my mouth. I've never been on this trail, I know that. I've been up that road, I forgot. We came up here one time in the snow in my truck, Jessica and I, and we're, again, by ourselves, and it got to be more icy than snowy, so we turn around, but I've never been out here. We turn around where that gate was, because we got out here and see where the snow is. I think this is never really in the sunlight, and it was just super, super icy. Oh. Thought maybe that was in the road there. Okay, here goes. Big bit of wash there. So usually what I'll do, I'll come out here, I'll ride around, I'll go up Vines Creek and stuff. I usually don't get on the highway really to get to Harmon Den. You can get out here from Vines Creek. It's a really nice ride through the countryside, lots of beautiful farmhouses and pasture land. And then you get up around, you go in towards Max Patch and you can ride around. I usually come out right there at Harmon Den. I'll jump on the highway, ride the 8 miles to Tennessee, take the Waterville exit, and then come back to the area we live in North Carolina, through the Great Smoky Mountains National Park, the Cataloochee area of the park. But the other weekend I rode out there and they had the park was closed. And I didn't ride the, it said 4 miles ahead that the gate was closed. I was kind of tired. I didn't ride up there to see if I could get around the gate or not. But I probably will if they don't open it up this winter. Good thing these pants are waterproof and my butt would be really wet because it feels really cold right now. Whoa, almost lost the front there. That was my fault though, I had a little too much weight on the handlebars. This is some slick shit too, it's kind of clay. Wet clay. And again, these are much more of a street-oriented tire. Maybe when I stop, if I remember, I'll show you guys what these tires look like. They're the stock Africa Twin tires, and I've got about 5,000 miles on them. The front's still in pretty good shape, but the back doesn't have nearly as much tread as when it started. And it wasn't a real aggressive tire to begin with. See, what bothers me about those, they're super fun, but... You know, on a bike, you never know, like, is there a big rock in there? I can't see, so... And I hope for the best that you don't go swimming. But I've got some good gear on. I'm wearing a pair of Kevlar jeans with think it's D3PO level 2 armor in them, in the knees and hips. And then I'm wearing these Scorpion Seattle pants, waterproof pants. They don't have any armor. They came with some armor, but it wasn't rated or anything. It's just some cheap kind of foam armor. So I took the armor out, and I just wear my Kevlar riding jeans underneath. That looks really slippery. Let's stay out. Icy in that one. Starting to get a little bit less apt to play as much down in here because I don't know where I'm at. I don't know how often this road gets used, so if something happens, I'm going to end up walking out of here. There's another trail. You know, this might be a good place to stop for a few minutes and get some water and stretch out. See why my phone's playing techno music. So something else is kind of funny. This is the first time I've worn these boots too. I bought these. These are my road boots. They're some Alpine Star SMX perforated boots. They're doing really good. I have a pair of Alpine Star more motocross style boots that are like kind of cover the whole calf, big buckles on them. They're pretty gnarly. They don't articulate at the ankle at all, and they're very hard for me to walk in. So I haven't really ridden much in those. I've tried it twice now, and I might give it another go because they are a really nice boot. They'd probably do excellent out here like this. But again, if something happened and I ended up having to walk very far in those boots, oh, it would be really difficult. So these have worked out really good. I'm excited to try them on the Ducati next. I'm going to obviously have to get them cleaned up, but they're working really good. I have really good contact with the motorcycle with these, much more so than my hiking boots. So anyway, I only brought one battery, so this is probably going to be the end of the video. Welcome to the Pisgah National Forest. I hope you enjoyed riding along with me on my Africa Twin.